Hello, my name is Jim Keller. I'm a professor of pharmacy, medicine, and oncology out of the University of Texas at Austin in the Health Science Center in San Antonio. Today I'm going to talk about the pathophysiology of chemotherapy-induced nausea and vomiting, also referred to as CINV. When you talk about the proposed pathophysiology of CINV, there are basically three types of mechanisms for chemotherapy-induced nausea and vomiting. We have central, we have peripheral, and then we have a combination of the two. Let's start at the top with the central mechanism. Central mechanism is you start with activation of the chemotherapy trigger zone. The activation of the chemotherapy trigger zone invokes the release of neurotransmitters, and those stimulate the vomiting center. And once the vomiting center is stimulated, a person then gets efferent transmission into the body, into the diaphragm, into the stomach, into breathing, and you throw up. The peripheral mechanism is chemotherapeutic agents cause an irritation and damage to GI mucosa. When you see this damage to the GI mucosa, this also results in the release of neurotransmitters. These transmitters, again, through the vagus nerve, feed up into the vomiting center, and you also can throw up from a peripheral mechanism, also activating the vomiting center, causing the same vagal afferents. Then there's the combined mechanism where chemotherapy agents can both act centrally and peripherally, which is probably seen with many of the agents. This next slide shows the pictorial of that. And you can see here where we talked about cell damage in the GI tract on the bottom part of the picture. And that damage then causes activation of the vagus nerve. That vagus nerve then activates the CTZ zone that I mentioned up in the brain, and that then activates the vomiting center, and the vomiting center then will cause efferent or impulses out of the brain that then hit target organs and cause you to vomit. You can also see that you can have direct activation through the blood, because chemotherapy drugs are in the bloodstream, and they can directly activate the brain and or through the cerebral spinal fluid, causing the same activation of the vomiting center. This next picture shows in detail the chemicals being released as part of this process. If you look on the bottom of the slide in the left-hand corner, you can see this is the gut. These are the luminal cells of the GI tract. Chemotherapy, as we mentioned, can act peripherally. They can cause damage to cells called enterochromaffin cells, and these cells then will release a substance called serotonin. Serotonin is a substance that then activates the receptors in the vagus nerve, and that vagus nerve then feeds up into the area postrema, and that again is in the brainstem. And that then activates the CTZ, the chemotherapy trigger zone, that will activate the vomiting center. So it's those neurotransmitters there that are responsible for this activation. If you look up on the right side of this, you can see again up in the clinical, the central pathway here, you again have this vagal feed, and you can see here you have substance P being released, and that substance P will activate the neurokinin receptor, and that neurokinin receptor centrally in the brain can also activate the vomiting center, causing a person to vomit. So those are the two neurotransmitters that seem to be related to vomiting. The peripheral one from the GI tract is more associated with acute vomiting, and the centrally mediated substance P, or the neurokinin receptor, is more responsible for delayed vomiting, which we see often with chemotherapy administration. So summarizing this part of the pathophysiology, chemotherapy can act both centrally and peripherally to induce nausea and emesis from chemotherapy. The enterochromaffin cells in the GI mucosa are stimulated to release serotonin. The serotonin then stimulates the afferent vagus nerve fibers, which leads to the CTZ, the chemotherapy trigger zone, and that in turn stimulates the vomiting center, causing one to vomit. Also, though, through blood and CSF, you can have chemotherapy that can act directly on the vomiting center through a central mechanism, causing a patient to also vomit. So there can be two mechanisms, both central and peripheral, for nausea and vomiting induced by chemotherapy. That activation of the vomiting center then, once stimulating, causes an efferent or going away from the brain that stimulates salivation, breathing changes, and then stomach muscle contraction, and that stomach muscle contraction makes you vomit. Thank you very much, and that is the end of this session.